Can I just add a little balance?
Can you just give the mic to Mark?
Mayor's race.
You want to clarify something?
Well, I just want to add a little balance to the mayor's race, because, you know, the Kali Yuga elephant was certainly a part of it. But there was a more serious side. The man who ultimately was elected mayor that year was Maynard Jackson. And Maynard Jackson got a lot of association with devotees, and he got a lot of those bananas and,
a lot of percent,
and cherries and all the other things and cherries.
We should make a little part.
He loved prasadam. And one time at Atlanta Airport now, a lot of you may not remember, but Maynard Jackson died a few years ago. But he became a very good friend of the devotees. And so the airport's named for Maynard Jackson. And one time, someone in the press criticized us for trying to bring religion to politics, because in those days it was absolutely forbidden to say any religion in politics. And so Maynard Jackson took the microphone next. It was sort of a round table like this. And it was my turn to speak, and they criticized us. And so Maynard Jackson, the next person speaking, he said, I'm a follower of Martin Luther King, who was a follower of Mahatma Gandhi, who said that anyone who thinks they can separate religion from politics, or politics from religion, does not understand the nature of either. That was his old comment. And then Sam Massell, whose niece was a devotee, who was a prior mayor of Atlanta, was very good friends of devotees. And another one, Charlie Weltner, who had been a U.S. congressman from this area and eventually became the Chief Justice of the Georgia Supreme Court, is the one who passed the ruling that allows us to stay in this building today.
Let me ask you a
We had a case that went all the way to the Georgia Supreme Court about whether we could stay on this property, and he signed the opinion that allowed us to stay. That's Charlie Weltner, Sam Bissell, Maynard Jackson, and another person who became friendly with the devotees in the next race was Andrew Young, who is now, you know, became an internationally famous person.
I got him to sign the petition to run against him.
Right, Andrew Young. Andrew Young was very nice. I don't know if he's still alive.
He's still alive.
Very, very nice man, Andrew Young. All those are very nice men. And also, when that race was covered, on the evening news by Walter Cronkite, he went through the major candidates, which were Maynard Jackson and Charlie Weltner. In those days, they would always have a funny thing at the end of the broadcast. They said, and there's one other candidate who dresses in a, whatever they call it. And gives away fruit from the top of the lake. They had a picture, and that's the way it is. Good night, Chet. So that was
actually I remember that a little differently.
Yeah.
Actually, what Walter Cronkite said, that this was an unusual race because it wasn't based on Republican, Democrat. Anyone who came up with names on petition or paid $1,000 could be on the ballot. So there was a lot of, he mentioned the four major candidates, and then he said there's a lot of very fringe candidates, but there is one serious in that group, and he's the Hare Krishna candidate, William Ogle. Then they sort of picture of the Kali Yuga elephant with all these children following us. And because a couple of times we arrived at a program, and we were doing a competition with the kids that who could be louder, chanter or them. So we would go, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, and they'd have to chant louder, otherwise they wouldn't get watermelon or rotten bananas. And so we would arrive, and all the candidates would be standing outside. We'd arrive with all these big, like Pied Piper with all these children. Hari Bol, Hari Bol. And so Walter Cronkite said that Mr. Ogle's campaign introduced a different type of philosophy into the normal, you know, sort of cliche political campaign. And also, one other incident is with Charles Weltner. This is a very good story, is that Charles Weltner was smoking a cigarette. In those days, people would smoke in public. And I don't think Balabhanta was aware at the time that he was smoking a cigarette, but he said that we need leaders that we could trust. That was on our thing. Who can you trust? W-H-O, William H-O, who can you trust? And he was saying that trust was someone who could control their senses. And an example of someone who can't control their senses, that if someone is smoking and it says right on the side of the pack that, dear sir, if you smoke this cigarette, it will kill you, and you still smoke, that person can't control his senses. And so he's going like this as he's saying, he's slowly taking his cigarette. He's trying to, like, you know, put it out. Everybody's seeing this. And they all just start laughing. And he's like, and another thing with William, with Maynard Jackson, there was a TV interview that you were doing with him, you and him and someone else, and the person asked something about what do you like best about the campaign or what. Yeah, and Maynard Jackson said, actually, I'm so anxious for this, to be perfectly honest with you, the thing that I like the most is that, you know, that Krishna food, and I'm really anxious for this interview to end so I can go out and finish off what is left. And one other thing is, we got Hosea Williams, who was one of the main people, and he used to have a picture of Martin Luther King sitting in an armchair, with Gandhi above it, and Martin Luther King had a Bhagavad Gita, and he had that behind his seat in his office. And he was running for like vice mayor at the time, and he did a press conference with Balabhanta saying that he thought that he was the most God-conscious candidate. It was on the headlines, right? It was the headlines. Hosea Williams endorses William H. Ogle for mayor. Also, diametrically opposed, Lester Maddox also endorsed William H. Ogle as the most God-conscious candidate. And these two people were like completely opposite sides of the coin in the civil rights movement. So it was a very,
about the same issue. That same interview where the gentleman was smoking a cigarette and put it out, Balabhanta, he was really on a roll. So there was another candidate right before him who also spoke and was giving out garbage bags to everyone with his name on it, saying, we got to clean up the city, we got to clean up the city. So Balabhanta, in his speech, he said, everyone should be, a real leader knows how to engage everyone according to their propensities. So if someone wants to, you know, clean the city and be a garbage collector, then they should just be a garbage department. They shouldn't be running for mayor. I mean, we were so bold. And Balabhanta would speak. There was a television interview, and we were all watching, and he's standing there looking just brilliant. He had a white jacket and suit, you know, top, and he's preaching and all the wonderful Bhagavatam knowledge about politicians and like this. And then all of a sudden, they kept the film on him, and he stands up and turns around, and they see his cigarette and his dirty. We all had to laugh so much. And in that interview, at the end, they asked, you know, they would ask all the different people who were in the audience. They're mostly reporters and supporters of the different candidates. They could ask questions to any candidate to keep the debate going. And so Gokularanjana Prabhu is in his orange dhoti and orange, you know, kurta, and he stands up very boldly. He says, I have a question. What is it? I can hardly say this. What is the duty of a man who is about to die? Got very nervous. And then of course was called upon to answer that very brilliantly.
We've been studying the class that was, what does it mean, man, when he's on the threshold of death? You know, on your threshold, which, and so I was, you know.
And Prabhupada wanted Balabhanda to be president of the United States, so.
Are you Garland, and I played it with Shadow, and I have that picture, actually. Yeah, it's very famous. This is the man that walked with Dr. Martin Luther King. But Maynard Jackson, he started an organization in Atlanta called Atlanta Religious Mobilization Against Crime. So I joined that organization on behalf of the temple. And I was at a luncheon meeting with old priests and ministers from Atlanta. And Maynard Jackson spoke that. He was a keynote speaker. And that evening on television, they interviewed him about the organization. He said, my organization is successful now because of Hare Krishna's of joy. So, Manaji, Jaya, Uri, is that correct?
Yeah.
Would you like to say a few words, please? Mahavir kind of said, I'll just smile.
No. Yes. That doesn't matter, you talked about problems.
He's a very good friend of this temple, and we love him very much. And give you this, you know, give a few words.
Where's the other place?
And then Songpo last year really gave us some beautiful nectar from New Vrindavan, so he'll close it out for us on that.
Hare Krishna. This is a wonderful opportunity for me to be here and see all these devotees. This is the second time I'm coming to the Alatra Temple, to the Atlanta Temple. I live in Alatra. And I'm, you know, initiated by Srila Prabhupada, and I have had association with Srila Prabhupada in Vrindavan.
Wow.
Got my Gayatri mantra there at the Vrindavan temple. This Panihati festival is such a powerful festival because it has Varnachananda's mercy ingrained in it. So there's a lot of spiritual energy that is created by that mercy. So just to be here and feel the energy that's in this room and the consciousness of all the devotees, this is very inspiring. Thank you very much.
Well, unfortunately, I wasn't here during all those great years in Atlanta, but fortunately, I've become very good friends with a lot of devotees who have come from here. I'm speaking closer to the microphone, so Alachua, you can all hear. Atlanta just kind of grows on you, no matter where you live. We live in Florida, and the Atlanta Temple and devotees from Atlanta, and there's a lot of devotees in Alachua who come from Atlanta. It just kind of over the years takes its toll on you. It's a great place. Good things always happen here. It's a beautiful temple. The devotees are so nice. We're so happy about how we're received when we come here. And on a special note, what I thought I might just share with you is I guess it's when I first met Jai Bhattacharya Maharaj, Acharya Bhattacharya. It was in Mayapur.